You've got questions? Andrew Mason has the answers. This is Mason's Mailbag, presented by Prime Sport.
The Week 11 Mailbag. I'm Andrew Mason. Thanks for joining me here on DenverBroncos.com. Let's get started with a question about punt returners. What do you expect from Jordan Taylor as the punt returner? This question from Al Burgess. Well, the first thing I expect is for him to focus on catching the ball. That's the first priority when you have him getting the job, because the previous punt returner, Isaiah McKenzie, had 5 fumbled punts to this point in the season. The priority is catching the football. Anything else beyond that, that's a secondary concern. Now, if there's open territory in front of Jordan Taylor, you expect him to take advantage of it. The biggest issue is catching the punt, because you're trying to find ways to reduce turnovers. The interceptions and giveaways on offense when the game was close and competitive, those have largely gone away. But you still have special teams giveaways, and certainly make sure the offense has a chance to take over and reduce the risk of giveaways. Right now, the Broncos have the second most giveaways in the NFL. There is probably no more predictive statistic than turnover margin. And so this move is designed to help fix that. The priority for Jordan Taylor, catch the football, protect the football, because that's a big part of the reason why the Broncos have struggled in recent weeks. Next question from Paul Houston. Besides winning, of course, what made Red Miller a Ring of Fame coach? Well, winning obviously was the biggest thing. If you don't go to the playoffs 3 times in 4 years as head coach and not have a losing season, you're not going to the Ring of Fame like Red Miller will be on Friday night when his pillar is unveiled on Ring of Fame Plaza. But the big thing I think that Red Miller brought was a change in attitude. We had a chance to talk with Randy Gradishar, Ring of Fame linebacker, on Orange and Blue 760 on Thursday. And Gradishar talked about that change in attitude that Red Miller brought. And it was infectious. It was intensity in practice. But it was also the way he would relate to players. Gradishar talked about how Miller took time to meet with every player individually right after taking the job to kind of get a feel for things. He was an intense coach, and to the point where Gradishar said that game days were kind of a relief compared to the intensity of practices. Of course, he could do a lot more in practices in 1977 than you can right now. The rules are very different today, but he was very much a player's coach. They got the best out of each other. It's a big part of the reason why the Broncos won under Red Miller and why you'll see so many players from those 1970s teams back to honor the late Red Miller as he goes into the Ring of Fame. Great to see. We just wish that Red could have been around to see it, but no, one way or another, he'll be watching from somewhere. Thanks for the questions. If you want to join us next week, go to denverbroncos.com/Mason's Mailbag. Or find me on Twitter, @MaceDenver. Use the hashtag AskMace. Or join me on Orange and Blue 760 every weekday, Monday through Friday. Of course, next week, only Monday through Wednesday. So join us every weekday for 1st and 10 at 10. Until next time, take care and thanks for watching.